create an expense bill so that you have a fair idea of how expense bill creation is happening, the voucher is happening, and then the payment for the same is happening. So I'll choose a fund, I'll choose which department it belongs to, scheme. There are no schemes which I'm tagging it to. So fund source, in case you want to track from which fund source you are doing this payment or which fund source you are accounting it under, you can tag those fund source as well. So that you can generate report by fund source also at point of time. Okay. There's a function to just to fetch all the leaf level function codes which user can search by code or by text. Okay. This will be the party bill numbers which party has submitted. So I'll choose some running sequence number which I maintain, or which if it is coming from the same party, we'll have this sequence number which is followed. So bill date. So there's a running summary that you can see here. Total debit amount, credit amount, net payable, which will flow through the screen so that user will have an idea of what is the total amount debit and total credit. And we can also do a cross check before the transaction is posted or saved. Pay to, so I'll just say contractor one. So I can tag this expense bill to a certain type of expenses. Okay. I can say it is an advanced GPF. So user can define this bill subtypes. This is the MIS information. Will not have impact on how the bill is processed. Okay. So there is contractor bill and supplier bill separately created here. So, but all the expenses can be tagged or can be processed using expense bill as well. Okay. So I'll just say it's a deposit or some contingent expenses only. Subledger type. If it is linked to a subledger type, I can choose the subledger over here and choose that contractor code over here. So the contractor code which I have given was, like, which I have created is 1234. I can choose this and the pay to will automatically get populated to that. Since this is not a subledger based payment, I will choose to enter this manually. So there are templates. Okay, if there is a regular bill, like similar to salary bill has got about 15 to 20 components entered as various deductions, earnings and deductions and the net payable. So this is a standard template which is used across department, across functions on a monthly basis. So those kind of entries or bills can be created as template. So once we load that template, you can choose a template based on the bill type and for a particular subledger, and load that and post, or you can automatically fetch all those account codes to be defaulted over here. Add those entries over here by default. Okay. If the templates are created, so you can see that. If not, I'll just leave some telephone expenses. Communication telephone expenses. I'm just leaving. If there are deductions, I can add in deductions over here. If not, the net payable account will be, this is fetched based on the purpose ID, which I spoke about in the chart of account masters. Okay. So once I enter this, you can see the running that you will see on the screen, overlapping the screen. So this is the debit amount 6,000. There is no deductions for that. And the net payable is 6,000. So which is automatically getting calculated and updated over here based on the net amount and the deduction that user has chosen. Okay. Now, once that is clear, I update as I click on done. So the detail or a summary of the ledger posting that would be happening for this transaction will be shown here. Okay. If there are subledger details for this posting, you can see that as well in this section. So the supporting documents can be uploaded here as a proof of expenses or proof of expenditure. And since, yeah, so this will go through a workflow. This will generally be done by the accounts executive or junior accounts officer who is there in the account section, who will be responsible to create all the bills. If the expense bill access is extended to the other department account, unit's accounting cell or accounts user of that particular department would create this expense bill and process it to the account section for approval or within the department itself. Okay, then it comes for voucher creation to the actual account section. Okay. So since we are not going through the workflow, if you choose this will be the users which will be loaded based on department and destination that you select, and user can choose any of the user to whom it has to be forwarded. So this can be again configured as per the flow or as per the defined or constrained flow based on the needs. So what to be listed in department and what to be shown in the designation and so on for various types of bills. So that is again a customization or configuration that you will have to make in the workflow matrix. Okay, so you can submit his comments and forward it to the next level. So that will go through various level, and at the third level, so right now it is 3 level of approval that we have configured, or 2 level of approval if the matrix is defined. If matrix is not defined, the forwarding will keep getting forwarded. Okay, so since that is the workflow is not defined on this instance, we'll directly create an approval. This user is only creating it and approving it also. So this option is given for helping them to adopt the financial system or accounting system at the initial stages. So wherein they have the parallel run happening for the financial module adoption, at which they process it through the workflow, and for the impact of the same in the system, they directly create and approve certain transaction. The bill voucher is already processed, and they create a bill and showcase the impact or record the impact of that transaction at the final level. Okay, so this is again based on the configuration, will be shown up to 31st March of this year. If I extend that again, it will continue to show. Otherwise, it will only show up to 31st March of 2021. So, right, I'll create and